give us exactly what we need.
All right.
I'm a witness that if you pray and pray right then,
yes, sir,
then he'll answer your prayers.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a witness.
Yeah.
And I'm not just saying that as a cliche, but when I tell you, he has answered every one of my prayers.
All right.
I just fell out with him a week ago, and when I tell you.
All right, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm telling you now. I'm telling you now.
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you.
Yes,
prayer works. I mean, and I'm like I said, I'm not trying to pump and prime, because if you ain't praying and if you don't believe it works, there's something wrong.
Yeah, all right. All right, sir.
Trust me when I tell you that we living right now.
Yes, sir.
We are actually in a being of prayer.
All right, sir.
And those of us that are more seasoned than us, that's how we got through.
Yes, sir.
Because when we couldn't pray for ourselves, somebody prayed for us. When we didn't have the mind to pray for ourselves, somebody prayed for us. So I just want us to just bind together. And just and when I tell you, they say little prayer, little power. Much prayer, much power. So I'm just asking if every member just collectively just pray for St. Luke as a whole. Pray for each individual. Pray for folks that you know and that you don't.
Yeah,
right, amen.
Yeah.
So let's just go to God and pray right
now.
Lord God, we're coming right now, Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
Thanking you for being God and God alone, Heavenly
Father. All right.
Lord, I ask right now, Heavenly Father, that you teach me how to pray and even what to pray for, Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, that you just gird me, Heavenly Father.
Yes,
Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, that you just continue to prop me up on every leading side. And then, Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, to just continue to be a firm foundation, Heavenly Father. Continue to be a shelter over my head, Lord. Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, to just continue to regulate my mind. Continue to be a heart fixer. And Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, that if there's someone that needs you to be a burden bearer, I ask that you could go back into that realm, Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask, Heavenly Father, that we all remember and realize that you're God and God alone. Because you don't have to ask a certain person or ask a certain being, what can I do for this child? You can do what you want to. And I like that, Heavenly Father. Because some people look at us and look at the outside of us, but I'm just glad that you get on the inside, Heavenly Father. And you look from the inside out, Lord. Meaning that you're standing in the middle of our house, Heavenly Father, and looking on the outside, Lord. Continue to be God. Lord, I ask Heavenly Father that you continue to sit high and look low. Because realize that sometimes we get low. But I heard him say that you lay low in Zion. Not only do you lay low in Zion, but they said that you are precious, elect cornerstone. And when you say cornerstone, we realize that that's the foundation, Heavenly Father. If you got a good cornerstone, you can build on it. So I just want us to build our hopes on things eternal and just continue to hold to your unchanging hand, Lord. I'm glad about that. I'm glad that you ain't wishy-washy. I'm glad that you ain't funny-acting, Heavenly Father, but you're stationary. The same God that you was back then, the same God right now, and the years to come, Heavenly Father, and that's good news, that you don't change. So that means that if Isaac, Abraham, and Jacob, and Job, and Daniel, and Matthew, and Mark, and Luke, and John, and all those that are called on you back then, Heavenly Father, why you still can hear us right now, Heavenly Father? I just thank you for being all-knowing God, a foreknowing God. I thank you, Heavenly Father, that you are the great I am. Lord, I don't have to ask you to go into the hospitals. I don't have to ask you to go into the nursing homes. I don't have to ask you to go to the prison, Heavenly Father, because I heard it said, and I'm trusting and believing in your word, that you're everywhere present and nowhere absent. That's a big God, Heavenly Father. That means that you can see us when we can't, when we know, when we think you can't, Heavenly Father. And I'm glad about that, Lord. So that means that when I feel that I'm down in the valley, that you're right there, Heavenly Father. Oh, but when I get onto the mountaintop, Heavenly Father, you have to sometimes bring us down, Lord. So that means that you're right there with us, Heavenly Father. So I'm asking, Heavenly Father, to just go with us and stand by us, Heavenly Father. And then, Lord, I ask, Lord, that you just forgive us of our sins, both known and unknown. throne, Heavenly Father. Realizing that we're just sinners saved by your very grace, Heavenly Father. I just thank you for allowing grace and mercy to abide in our lives, Heavenly Father. To go with us, Heavenly Father. Each day of this journey, Heavenly Father. But I'm glad that I'm just a pilgrim passing through. This ain't my home down here, Heavenly Father. Oh, but I got a home that's built eternal. Not made by man, Lord. That's good news, Heavenly Father. That's good news. And I just want to one day hear my name called. I just want to know that my good outweighed my bad, Heavenly Father. And Lord, when you call my name and tell me that I've been faithful over a few things, come on up higher and I'll make you a rule. I don't have to be a rule over anything, Lord. I can just be somewhere around your throne. Of this church, let them help them to realize and make sound decisions, Lord. Help them to realize that we can't do anything without love, Heavenly Father. It says it in your word, Heavenly Father, that if you don't have love, you're just making noise. I said if you don't have love in your heart, and if it don't show, you're just making noise. So I just ask, Heavenly Father, to just continue to let love abide, Lord. And if there's any malice or hate or jealousy or envy in any of us, Heavenly Father, do what only you can do, Heavenly Father. Purge us right good, Heavenly Father. Take us down to the Potter's house and mold us into what you would want us to be, Heavenly Father. And if that don't work, Heavenly Father, take us again, Heavenly Father. I'm asking you right now, Lord, to fix us up for long time traveling. And I ask this in your darling, precious Jesus' name. Amen.
Says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and to his courts with praise. Sound like Deacon Berkeley came ready. That's all right. We're going to read Galatians, the 6th chapter. And we'll start at the first verse. Brothers and sisters, if someone is caught in a sin, you who live by the Spirit shall restore that person gently. But watch yourselves, or you also may be tempted. Carry each other's burdens, and in this way you will fulfill the law of Christ. And if anyone thinks they are something when they are not, they deceive themselves. Each one should test their own actions. They can take their pride in themselves alone without comparing themselves to someone else. For each one should carry their own load. Nevertheless, the one who receives instruction in the word should share all good things with their instructor. Do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. A man reaps what he sows. Whoever sows to please their flesh, from the flesh will reap destruction. Whoever sows to please the Spirit, from the Spirit will reap eternal life. Let us not become weary in doing good. For at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Therefore, as we have an opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers. I have read to you Galatians, the 6th chapter, the 1st through the 10th verse. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy and divine word. Amen. We're going to have the praise team at this time.
Come on, let's give God some praise in this place this morning. Are y'all too quiet for me? Come on, give God some praise in this place. Because he's worthy to be praised, God. How many believe that he's able? How many know that he's able? How many even think about that he's able? Hallelujah. Thank you, God. You know, when I came in this morning, I wasn't feeling too well, and I said I was going to go to the emergency room. But I said, the devil is a lie. Yeah. I'm going to come here and get my praise on. So anybody want to come and praise him this morning with me? Stand up on your feet and put your hands together, because I know my God is able. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Come on.
He's able, I know my God is able.
He's able,
know that after he's able, we can be free. Anybody free in the place today? Sometimes we can be held captive in bondage under our own mess. Sometimes the enemy is in the end of me. Hallelujah. Do I get any folks that wants to be free today? Free from everything. Free from trials and tribulations. Listen. You thought I was worth saving. So you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping. So you I got to get personal now. You don't know what I had to do to push myself through these doors. I said, well, Lord, I don't feel good right now. Should I go to the emergency room? Or should I just go to the church house? Did y'all know there's healing in the church house? Did y'all know there's deliverance in the church house? Whatever you need, it's right here. It's right here. Anybody need something in the house today? I dare you to lift your hands and surrender.
Great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. So thankful that the Lord made you, so thankful for your kindness too. From Goody Evans and family, we want to thank you for being there in our time of bereavement. We are thankful for our Sanctum Church family. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Continue to keep him in your prayers. May God bless you for your thoughtfulness and expression of sympathy shown to us during our time of bereavement. Thank you from the Ross family. There's a note also. First, I want to say thank you so much for the prayers and cards, flowers. I know that this is where I'm supposed to be with the big, strong, loving church family. I thank you all for your prayers. It really made me feel good inside. I give God the glory for while you still have time and joy will come in the morning. Please thank you. God bless you and keep you in Jesus' name. Amen. From Brother Al Ross.
Right. Amen.
I'm going to make a quick announcement. Most of you probably have kind of heard already. Brother Randy Maupin passed away last night. Obviously, Marilyn Maupin is in the back. And her family, they're always here faithfully. We want to continue to keep them in our prayers as they're going through this time of bereavement. I said it last week. I'll say it again. Marilyn and your entire family, it's okay for you all to be weak.
All right.
I shared it with Brother Goody last week.
All right.
Those of us that are believers are supposed to be strong during that time of weakness. And so she should be able to feed off of us to gain some strength. Amen?
Amen.
So we want to continue to keep that family surrounded in prayer.
Amen.
Continue to just go by, visit, love on them, right?
Amen.
And there'll come a day when people stop knocking on the door, Marilyn. Right? And you still got to be able to stay connected to the Lord.
Yeah.
All right? So we're praying with you. I love you. All right. Now our announcements. First one on the ballot. Minister Lewis Brown will be the MC. Is that today? This Sunday for Greater View Church. It is going to be today at 3:30. Please come out and support him. Amen?
Amen.
Easter egg hunt will be on Saturday, April 8th. It's going to be in the big field of Sudicum. We need plastic eggs. Our goal is to have 10,000 eggs. We also want any of you that can donate unisex bikes. Any candy and any of those things, please donate those. You can bring them down to the church. Mother Manny's here through the week, Monday through Thursday, 10 to 2. Auxiliaries, obviously she'll be assigning what our responsibilities are to bring those as well. Please don't forget to turn in your emergency contact forms. I think everybody's seen those at this point. If not, the ushers can get you one of those. So those can be turned in. Again, that's just for your own benefit. If something happens while you're at church, you get sick or whatever the case may be, we don't want to give you something that you don't need in a time of an emergency, right? And we want to know who to call on in case they're not here. Amen? Amen. Wednesday midday Bible study still going on at noon. And then, of course, we have Wednesday night Bible study at 7 p.m. Please keep the sick and shut in prayer. Again, I already mentioned Sister Malcolm and her family. Of course, we know about Goody and Al, and there's several others that are still. It seems like the death angel's been busy here. It seems like it's one every week. So we ought to just continue to be prayerful at all times. We want to say thank you to all the men and women that came out to help unload the truck on yesterday, I believe. We had a few good men here, from what I understand, and we're thankful for your service. Amen. The choir will be selling snacks immediately after church. Please come out and support. St. Luke Primitive Baptist Church Mass Choir, please join us. Reunion choir rehearsal, calling all current and previous St. Luke members. If you ever went to St. Luke or sang in the choir, if you ever visited St. Luke, join us. Rehearsal dates are every Thursday at 7:30 p.m. And our concert date will be April 30th, 2017 at 3 p.m. Amen?
Amen.
We are planning to have our new member mixer, which will be at the end of this month. Sister Grayson and Sister Nomika are spearheading that. So that'll be the last Wednesday of this month. I think that's the 26th. Is that correct, Sister Grayson? Wednesday, March 26th. So all new members, we have a meet and greet. We try to do it once a quarter. You can come meet the leadership and the different auxiliaries. We have small little food and snacks and things of that nature. The 29th, I said the wrong date. March 29th, which is a Wednesday, at 6 p.m. Amen? And now I'm going to ask Sister Beverly Wade if she'll come on behalf of the Homecoming Committee and make their announcement.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. I can't hear y'all. Praise the Lord, everybody. Ain't God good? Amen. Anytime we get a chance to praise God, you know, some of the people in other countries can't praise God, but we know where all our help comes from. I'm going to praise everywhere I can. Amen. Amen. So on behalf of the Homecoming Committee, we will be celebrating our 150th celebration at this church, in this building. This building has been here on the dead end street of Lewis Street for 150 years. Amen. And so we just want to say, well, let's get it together. Our taxation, each auxiliary is $500. Okay? So team leads, auxiliary heads, make sure you let all your people know. $500 taxation. Each member is $150. Now this homecoming celebration is going to be the fourth Sunday in August. So we got plenty of time to get our monies, get them turned in, and be sure you put your monies in the special offering envelope.
Amen.
Put your name on it, please, because if you don't put your name on it, you just put that check, well, your money on in there without a name on it, we don't know who to give you credit for. It's very important that we have everybody's name on the envelope, because you may say, I paid my money, we don't have a record of it. So it's very important we do that. Okay? So we just want to say, let's get ready, let's jump start this thing, and let's have a hallelujah good time in the name of Jesus on our 150th homecoming down the
road. Amen. 150 years, I said it, I'll say it again. I don't know too many churches that can say that. And this church has been here for 150 years. So I'm grateful to just be a part of the ministry. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I know we did this last week. We're going to do it again today. There's somebody in the back whose birthday who recently celebrated, which was Nomika. Everybody wave your hand because they know who you are. We want to say happy birthday to her. She is our choir president, and since I've been here, the short time that I've been here, she's always been faithful. She serves well. Give her a round of applause for another year of life. Amen. Sean Bradley is today. Well, amen. Wave your hand, Sean. Happy birthday to you as well. And I almost forgot, Brother Dennis. He just had his father pass away, correct? And so he'll be having a ranch. Raise your hand so everybody know who you are. Let's keep him in prayer as well. Amen. All right. We're going to do our St. Luke Fellowship song. I want you to hug at least 10 people. Say you love them. Share something encouraging with them. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
How y'all doing?
See me singing. Amen. 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 Ain't God good? Amen. Hey, it's blessing me this morning. Amen. It's silent and blessing me. I'm just gonna be honest with you. This morning I came from, I was sitting a little bit under the weather. But Sister Rachel, she said, you don't need to go to the hospital. You can find it right here. Okay. Then they got the same. Y'all, hey, I don't think y'all heard me. They got the same. It's a difference between singing and singing. So when they started singing, it got down in me. Yeah, man, it got down in me and my feet started moving. My heart got to jumping. Something came all over me. I feel better now. I like a lot of old rhythm and blues music. And the Isley Brothers is one of my favorites. They had a song said, take me to the next phase. I'm ready to go to the next phase. I'm ready to go to the next phase. Now, I don't know about you, but I come to worship the Lord this morning. Amen. 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 So at this time, we're just going to, it's time to lift up our offering. Amen. Come on, I'm up to home, man. This is the next phase of the service. Amen. 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 I just want to thank God for this day. Amen. Anytime I get an opportunity to thank him, because he didn't have to wake me up, but yet he did. Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, folks. for myself.
Sitting way back in the woodshop, and at this church, they had a choir that could sing real good. And at this church, they had an old deacon there, and every Sunday morning, he would ask the rector, can you sing this song? Why the rector looked at the old man, said, old man, you too old to sing in this choir. You know when you get old, people want to push you all aside. When they went back the next Sunday morning, they noticed that the old man wasn't sitting there. When they went back the next Sunday morning, they noticed that the old man was still sitting there. Somebody began to give word. They began to ask questions, y'all. Has anybody seen the old man? Anybody heard from the old man? And while they were sitting there, about that time, they heard a voice come down from him. And if y'all don't mind, if y'all don't mind, if y'all don't mind, can I tell you what the voice said just one time? It said, I found me a choir that will let me sing. Y'all hear me sing. Sing it. Oh. Listen. About that time they recognized who the voice was. And the voice said, what I like about this choir that I sing with now is that we don't have to wait till Sunday morning. But every morning me and the angels get together and we sing the songs out. And if y'all don't mind, I ain't gonna worry you long. If y'all don't mind, if y'all don't mind, if y'all don't mind, can I tell you what the Lord said just one more time? This is what the Lord said. That will let me sing, I, hallelujah. Lord, I'm singing. Yeah. One of these old days, yeah. We won't have to worry about the wind of the world. There won't be no more senior choir. There won't be no more junior choir. How many of you wanted that to say? In the heavenly choir. Well, we know tenor section and alto section and soprano section, but we just all get together just singing one big old choir. Won't be no big eyes or little U's or who lead this song. We just all gonna sing. But how do you know this is just a rehearsal down here? Amen. 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 Second in the heavenly choir. He's gonna say it one more time. So good, and he is greatly to be praised. Let us pray. Dear God, our Father, how we thank you for this time right now, God. God, we come right now just to say thank you. We ask that you give us preaching power now, God. Bring back to remembrance those things that we have prepared, and that your people be receptive to receiving. God, we thank you. Father God, we thank you that you allowed the death angel to ride over our house, and you were able to let us see a day that we've never seen before. And come midnight tonight, it'll be a day that we'll never see again. But God, we say thank you. Now right now, God, I ask that you hide me behind the cross, that they may see you and not see me. God, we just give you the praise and the honor. So let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and my redeemer. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You have your Bibles. You will turn with me to Exodus. The 13th chapter. Amen. When you get to the 13th chapter, go down to verse 17. There you will find these words recorded. And it came to pass when Pharaoh had led the people go, that God led them not through the way of the land of the Pharisees. Although that was near, for God said, lest peradventure the people repent when they see war and they return to Egypt. But God led the people about through the way of the wilderness of the Red Sea. And the children of Israel went up harmless out of the land of Egypt. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want to start this message just gonna talk today.
Come on.
I prophesied to somebody. God is still in control. Doesn't matter what is happening in the economic situation. It does not matter what's happening in the political level or who's in the White House. Does not matter what they do in social security, health care, anything else. God is in control. It's not the government or the president or anybody else. As a child of God, your destiny is secure. God is your secure. Your source of heaven never has a shortage or never needs a bailout because God is in control. So I want to talk from the subject this morning, if you haven't caught it by now. God is in control. There are many times in life that from out of natural prospect, there are easy and faster ways to do things. But God has a better viewpoint. Plus, God has a higher purpose. Too many times our intention is to get through it, go through it. But God's intention is for us to grow through it. But here are the children of God, from all visible evidence, they are trapped. You know the story. Pharaoh had captured them. Then he let them go. They wanted to get on the freeway and just fly by. God had to take them the long way. But that's how God has to do some of us. You know how it is. If you live here in South Nashville, you can go down the street, go across the bridge. You in East Nashville. You can turn the corner, go around the corner. You in Madison. Go on down the street, you be in North Nashville. But have you ever been driving and sometimes you try to take another route? And that route's blocked up too. And it takes you more time to get where you really want to get to. But that's what the children of Israel were. They were trapped. There was no way back. There was no way forward. They were in a place no one ever wants to be. The thing we have to fight is agree with the enemy. And we must not agree with the devil because God is in control. See, the devil knows the power of words. He wants you to line up your confession with your circumstances. But God wants you to line up your confession with his word. Fear says, it's over. There's no way out. Bury me with my boots on. But faith turns around and says, I don't know what God is going to do. And I don't know how, but I know God has it under control. Some of you may not realize, but there's an enemy that we've been fighting with since the beginning of time that's been in our lives. You get it under control, but out of nowhere, somebody pushes your button. Up pops that. Okay, don't y'all sit in here and act like y'all holy. Then die. Only this Sunday. Some of you may not say nothing. And you may not want to agree right now because you might be sitting next to somebody. You done did something too. Amen, lights. If you look this way, keep looking this way, you won't be guilty. Amen. But everybody that say they for you ain't for you. You know how it is when you do everything you can do for people. You get exhausted and You're at the point of giving up. You're at the point of saying, you know what, I ain't gonna help them Negroes no more. That's it. I'm through. But God is still in control. That same one you said you wasn't gonna help. Something will happen and turn it around and you'll go back and help them. But God is still in control. The Lord tells Paul this way, says, my grace is sufficient for thee, and my strength made perfect in weakness. But how do you handle life when you know God is in control, but you try to be in control? How do you handle life when God tells you to take your hands off, but you put your hands in anyway? And things happen. You think you just living on the easy street. Some of y'all sitting in here right now. Happy now than you've ever been. Because it's income tax time. Amen. You just as happy. You done come to church January, February, March. You ain't missed a Sunday. April. Come May and June. You go missing in action. You know how it is. Y'all know, don't act funny with me. You know how it is. Get a little something, something. Yeah. And you forget about it. Yeah. The ones that didn't have what you got. Yeah. Some of y'all sitting in here, you got some of the best cars there is. Yeah. But you forget about the people that's sitting on the bus stop. Yeah. You drive by and you wave your hand or blow it. Instead of stopping and saying, thank you, Marilyn. It's true. Some of y'all sitting there acting like y'all don't know what I'm talking about, but you know. You done it. I got to get where I'm going. Ain't that so-and-so standing out there? But God is still in control. Where you get that car, you get that home, and you think you're doing good. Everything's going well. Get up and you go to work. Come back home. The water heater busts. Kids need shoes. You need food. But you sit there at the table and you got your money and you say, do I pay the bills or let me come down some of y'all's street? Do I go kick it? See, some of y'all don't like this kind of preaching.
Come on.
Y'all like for us to go to E flat and hoop. I get that in a minute, but sometimes you gotta talk to people. Because we got to quit just thinking we can live any kind of way. And God gonna bless us anyhow. You're not doing anybody a favor by coming to church on Sunday morning and raising hell on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. You're not doing God no favor. Because what if you were at Jazzy Sensation trying to turn it up? And God turned it off. So I know I got some witnesses in here.
Come on.
See, some of the older people, they probably don't know about that, but y'all remember about New Era? Yeah. Uh-oh. Y'all didn't think I knew about that. Y'all said, well, she young, she don't know about that. Huh? Y'all knew about songs, huh? Not in fact. Oh, come on, come on. Y'all know about the last $2? Okay. Okay. Amen. You do know that. But how many of you know that back then when you was doing that, God was still in control? I said last week, you don't look like what you've been through because God is still in control. But God wants to do something in your life He has never done before. And to do that, He has to bring you to a place you've never been before. But what does He want to do, preacher? He wants to change your life. Let me give you something real quick.
Come on, guys, take the time.
God works on the night shift. The greatest miracles in your life may be 1 hour away just before daybreak. See, when the children of Israel closed their eyes that night, the Red Sea was in front of them. But when they opened their eyes that morning, there was an 8-lane highway in front of them. Here was the most awesome thing, that through the midst of the Red Sea, there was dry land. If you use your mind, you're thinking, how can a highway get in the middle of a sea? But I told you, God is in control. Many times I have to use Deacon Butler. Many times I go fishing with Deacon Butler and my husband and his son. We all get out and go fishing, and a lot of times we'll sit there and we'll cast out and sit. And sit. And sit. It ain't called nothing. Me being who I am, I look at him and I look at my husband and I look at his son. And I'll say, Mother Ross, I'm ready to go. And they'll say, no, we're gonna sit a little longer. And we'll wait a little longer. And sooner or later, Janelle, we get ready to leave. I start wanting to pick up stuff and get ready to put it in the car. And something will tug on the line. And Deacon said, you got something on there. And as I'm reeling in, I'm thinking, what could be on the other line? Is it a turtle? Is it a bluegill? Is it a bass?
Yeah.
Is it a crappie?
Yeah.
Is it a striper? What is it?
Yeah.
But sooner or later, when I reel it in, I see it's a catfish. But when I pick it up, it's still. So what I do is I reach over and I get the pliers.
Yeah.
And grab it by the lip. And when I take the hook out, it stops flat. You missed it right there.
Come on, come on.
I said, when I take out the hook, it stops flapping, Miss Jackie. And it just steal. But what the fish don't know is I done took control of the fish. So it can't flap no more. Cause it's out of a place that it's not used to being out of. But I'm getting ready to go to my seat. May the Lord God bless you real good. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. But when you, God is in control, it's like the three Hebrew boys that was in the fiery furnace. The king turned up the heat. And he said, didn't I cast in three? But I look in now and I see four. And he looks like the Son of Man. Well, the reason why is because God is in control. So when the three Hebrew boys came out, they didn't have nothing wrong with them because God was in control. But what about Daniel, who was in the lion's den? They thought the lion was going to eat him up. Come on, musicians, I'm ready to go. But the Lord made the lion lock his jaws in. He used him for a pillar. God was in control. Well, St. Luke, that's Luke over almost a year. Deacon Frazier, and pastor's gone. And here we are in March. People are coming in. Still giving God praise. God is still in control. When I look at Sister Marilyn and I look at Brother Goody, he done buried a loved one. And Brother Dennis, he's getting ready to bury the father. But in the midst of it, God is still in control. When I look at the Jones family, and I look at Brother Jones sitting here. Yeah. Yeah. In the midst of burying your wife, but God is in control. You're going to catch it in a minute. I look at Sister Diane sitting in the wheelchair now. What the doctor said, but here it is now, and God is still in control. Some of y'all that done lied on people and talked about people that mistreated them. But God is still in control. I look at Deacon Wilson, who's sitting here with his son, and he done buried your sister, but God is still in control. Well, I just want y'all to do something. Breathe in and breathe out. God is still in control. Al, we sent Aunt Johnny home last Sunday. You know, had a homecoming. Had a good old time. You know, good old church time. You know, quartet church time. You know. But God was still in control. Some of y'all sitting there looking at me strange, but you know you done some wrong. You should have been took out long time ago, but God is still in control. And you sit here looking at me. Well, over 2,000 years ago, on a hill called Calvary, they hung him high and stretched him wide, put nails in his hands and nails in his feet, pierced him in the side, and blood and water came streaming down. But he messed around, put a crown of thorns around his head. But he looked up to him, toward heaven, and said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. But then they took him down, put him in Joel's of new tomb. Stay there all night Friday night. Stay there all day Saturday. Stay there Saturday. his head. He said, well, we got you scheduled on the 31st of this month to do another test. But the first test don't look like which what it looked like 2 weeks ago. I said, well, what you don't know, I'm connected to a man that never lost a patient. And he said, by his stripes, I am healed. So you go ahead and do what you got to do. And I'm going to keep on talking to my doctor. So next week, when they get ready to call me, I'm going to walk on in and I'm going to tell the doctor, you do what you got to do. But I'm already healed. Somebody say yeah.
control. God is in control. We heard the preach word. This is the time. No matter what you're going through, come on down to the altar. No matter what you're going through, God, He is in control. He can raise up a bow down hill. He can ease a troubling mind.
We've done as the Lord has commanded, but yet there's still room.
Yeah.
Amen. There's still room.
Come on.
You've heard the preached word. And I pray that something was said today that would have someone running. Say, what must I do to save myself? What must I do to be saved? Now, I'm not in here to take your inventory. You know what you're dealing with. And I am one of these ministers. I want to talk to you. We deal with so much stuff that we like to sweep under the rug. That we like to, we know what we're dealing with. But we want to wrestle with it and continue it. But God is telling me to tell you right now, if you want to be free from it, come on down. You've been wrestling with some stuff. You've been toying with some stuff. It's been some stuff that's been keeping you up all night. That's making your health bad. God is a healer. God is a deliverer.
Outside of the cross, that he prepared.
married and died and rose the third day. Alright. Make sure Papa Kenneth for baptism. Let's see you next week. We'll see you baptized on the next Sunday. Amen.
Let me let y'all know something. This young man came this morning, and he came to Sunday school, and he came in and he said that he wanted to be an example for his friends. And he said that he reads his Bible, and when they want him to do other things, he stays in the Word. And I told him to just keep on keeping on. And I'm just so grateful that he is came to join church this morning, because you don't know who you sit next to. You may be sitting next to an angel. And I thank God that he made the right decision to give God his life.
You got this information, Mother Manny? We already have this information, right? Okay, that's fine. We'll get with you next week, like I said, I'll take you to the water. Amen, St. Luke. Give him a round of applause. Deacon Wilson already shared with me, he's going to go into the water with me on next week. But we be prayerful over the young men in this community. He's given his life to Christ. He's been intentional. He came to Sunday school this morning. We got to surround this young man. Right? And I don't know him, but somebody here might know him. And if you see him going the wrong way, stop him. Right? Corral him, encourage him to do the right thing. Amen?
Amen,
amen, St. Luke. I got two announcements we're going to get out of here. First is Michael Mooney needs to meet with all the male ushers right after service. The second thing is the pastoral search committee. We will meet tomorrow night. We won't meet tonight after service, as already previously discussed. So Monday night at 7 for the pastoral search committee. And then the last thing is, we do have a guest church coming. They should be showing up any minute here. I think they're running a little late, but they'll be coming to baptize. So if you guys can kind of exit quickly and quietly after we do benediction. Don't forget that we do have the choir selling next door. So please go out and support them as they're selling. Amen?
Amen.
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 Any other announcements that I may be missing? All right, Mr. Fife, you'll come and give us our benediction.
Let me publicly say this. Deacon Frazier, come here. I want to say this. I thank God. I said, Miss Angela, I'm gonna get you, Miss Angela. I promise. We ain't gonna leave without you saying what you need to say. Amen. But I want to say this publicly in front of everyone and to Deacon Frazier. I appreciate you giving me the opportunity to preach. You can pick anybody else, but I don't take this lightly. Some people take their gifts that God gives them lightly. I don't take it lightly. And so when I get the opportunity, I want to say thank you. I believe you give people their flowers when they live and not when they're down here. So I want to say thank you. Thank you so much. I love you and I love St. Luke. Anything y'all can do about it, amen. I will fight you for St. Luke, amen. And I work for Tennessee Department of Corrections. I'll get out of it, amen. Amen. They got lawyers, amen. But we have to be family. And that's how you have to do. Amen. You don't let nobody else beat up on your family. Amen. But I thank you, St. Luke. Continue to pray for me. Continue to lift me up. If you don't have anything to do next Monday night, I will be at Mount Carmel preaching next Monday night for them. And then the fourth Sunday in April, I'll be at Mount Perry Friendly Baptist Church doing their Women's Day at 11 o'clock. Now don't leave St. Luke and come. Amen. You come here first, amen. And then you can come over, but just pray. Pray for me, pray for my family. Amen. A lot of people say I'm a mama's baby. I am a mama's baby because I'm going to take care of my mama. Amen. I got a sister, but you'll catch that on the way home. I'll take care of my mama. Y'all pray for her. Amen. Amen. But let's just start loving one another. Amen. Amen. And all March birthdays, happy birthday, Sean. Be good now, Sean. Okay? All right. Miss Angela. Amen. So if there's nothing else, we're going to stand and we're going to be dismissed. Amen. If you know this song, let's sing a verse of this and then we're going to get out of here, okay? Thank you for this day. We thank you for what our eyes have seen and what our ears have heard. God, we thank you for letting us dwell with you today in your house. Now, God, as we get ready to leave this place, we ask that you give us traveling grace to make it back to our many different destinations. And when we get there, we find everything the same way we left it. And God, and tonight, if we lay down, you put your angel around our bedside. And if it's your will, we wake up in the morning. We say thank you. So it's in Jesus' name we pray. If you love the Lord, say amen.